गोश्त खाना कोई गलत नहीं है।
मैं नहीं जानता ऐसे लोगों को डॉक्टरेट की उपाधि क्यों दी जाती है, इनको डॉक्टर क्यों बनाया जाता है। बड़े बड़े हॉस्पिटल से बड़े बड़े डॉक्टर हैं जो मरीजों को मांस प्रेस्क्राइब कर रहे हैं, अंडा प्रेस्क्राइब कर रहे हैं। दुर्भाग्य की बात है उनको बेसिक नॉलेज नहीं। पशुओं की भांति अलग अलग जीव जंतुओं को पहले उपभोक्ता को दूसरे को तीसरे को मार करके खाता है, तो इनके शरीर में भी वो हानिकारक टॉक्सिन्स आ जाते हैं। अब इन जो टॉक्सिन्स हैं, ये केमिकल टॉक्सिन्स हैं, हानिकारक रसायन हैं जो इनमें पाए जाते हैं, इनकी खासियत होती है कि डिग्रेड नहीं होते, समाप्त नहीं होते। ये शरीर में आ जाते हैं, एक बार तो आ गए वो शरीर का हिस्सा हो गए, फिर शरीर से बाहर नहीं जाएंगे। इसीलिए आज का मनुष्य दो पैर वाला जहरीला पशु हो चुका है। उसको नहीं पता वो किसी को क्यों मार रहा है, वो अपने आप को क्यों मार रहा है। उसे नहीं पता माता पिता के साथ क्या व्यवहार करना, समाज के प्रति क्या मेरा कर्तव्य है, क्या व्यवहार करना, बच्चों को कैसे शिक्षा देनी है। उसको नहीं पता आप क्या कर रहे हो, तीन तीन चार चार साल की बच्चियों के साथ गलत काम कर रहे हो। इनका मूल कारण है हमारे शरीर में जहर की मात्रा किसी भी हानिकारक और जहरीले पशु के बराबर पहुंच चुकी है। क्यों? क्योंकि हमने शाकाहार छोड़ करके मांसाहार की तरफ हम बढ़ गए। फूड चेन हमने पढ़ी ही नहीं 10th क्लास में। यदि हम पढ़ लेते तो हम शाकाहार से पहले और दूसरे और तीसरे उपभोक्ता वाले जीवों को मारकर नहीं खाते। जैसे जैसे फूड चेन का लेवल बढ़ता जाता है वैसे वैसे उनमें जहर की मात्रा बढ़ती जाती है, और वो जहर खाने वाले में आता है जो शरीर से बाहर निकलता ही नहीं है। इसीलिए आज जहर की मात्रा मनुष्य के शरीर में बहुत ज्यादा बढ़ गई है।
वेरी गुड मुस्लिम इवन माई बींग अ प्योर वेजिटेरियन। इट्स नॉट फर्द इन इस्लाम दैट यू शुड हैव नॉन वेज। देयर इज नो वर्स इन द कुरान दैट यू शुड हैव नॉन वेज, और नो हदीथ इन विच द प्रॉफिट सेड इफ यू डोंट हैव नॉन वेज यू आर नॉट अ मुस्लिम। और बींग अ मुस्लिम यू शुड फॉलो द फोर क्राइटेरिया, ईमान, राइचियस डीड्स, वतवासबिर, सब्र, यू गो टू जन्नत। देयर इज नो क्राइटेरिया दैट यू शुड हैव नॉन वेज। बट you ask me the question, what is the logic that we have non-veg? Regarding a second part, you can be a good Muslim even by being a pure vegetarian, it's not fard. But what is the logic? The logic is, if Allah has given His permission to have non-veg, why should we not have it? Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Maida, chapter number 5, verse number 1, lawful for you is the meat of the four-footed animal with the exception named. Allah repeats the message in Surah Nahl, chapter 16, verse number 5, that you can have the meat of the animals. Allah repeats in Surah Mu'minun, chapter number 23, verse number 21, that verily in the cattle is a lesson for you. We give you to drink from what is within the body. From it you get warmth, and of the meat you can eat. So if Allah has given permission, why should we not have? Now scientifically, if we analyze, that the flesh food is rich in protein and vitamin K. Normally our body requires amino acid, 23 amino acids, out of which 8 essential amino acids, which are not synthesized in the body, which have to be given by external diet. There is no vegetable food which has all the 8 essential amino acids. No vegetable food. Even the soya bean, it is only the flesh food, meat, mutton, beef, fish, which have all the 8 amino acids. So it is nutritious. Coming to the logical aspect of it. If we analyze the set of teeth of the herbivorous animals which only have grass, which do not touch flesh food, cow, goat, sheep, they have a herbivorous set of teeth, they have flat teeth. If we analyze the set of teeth of the carnivorous animals which only have flesh food, lion, tiger, leopard, they have pointed set of teeth, they have a canine set of teeth, they have a carnivorous set of teeth. If we analyze our set of teeth and we go and look in the mirror, Almighty God gave the flat teeth as well as pointed teeth. If Almighty God wanted us to have only vegetables, why did He give us the pointed teeth? For what? For having non-veg. Furthermore, the digestive system of the herbivorous animal, the cow, goat, sheep, it can only digest vegetables, it cannot digest flesh food. The digestive system of the carnivorous animals, lion, tiger, leopard, can only digest flesh food, it cannot digest grass and vegetables. But the digestive system of the human being can digest both vegetables as well as flesh food. If Almighty God wanted us to be pure vegetarian, why did He give us a digestive system that can digest both? To have it. Furthermore, people have a misconception that non-veg is prohibited in our religion. Our religion means Hindus say, and they think, all the major scriptures of the world, they give permission to have non-veg. Even the Hindu scriptures. If you read Hindu scriptures, Manusmriti, chapter number 5, verse number 30, Almighty God says that Almighty God has created some animals to eat and some to be eaten. If you eat the animals which God has created to be eaten, you're not doing a sin. Manusmriti, chapter number 5, verse 31 says that Almighty God has created some animals for sacrifice. If you sacrifice the animals which are meant for sacrifice, you're not doing a sin. Again, the message is repeated, Manusmriti, chapter number 5, verse number 40, that you can kill the animals which are meant for sacrifice. There are, in Vedas, Rig Veda and all, there are quotations that sages and saints had beef, they even had cow. non-veg. They say, see, killing living creature is a sin. Therefore, we prefer having vegetables. Now science in advance have come to know that even the plants have got life. So when you have vegetables, you're taking life. So now the logic is saying, yes, Brother Zakir, plants have got life, but plants can't feel pain. Therefore, killing a plant is a lesser sin as compared to killing an animal. Today, science has further advanced and we have come to know that even the plants can feel pain. The plants even feel happy, they can even cry. But the cry of the plant cannot be heard by the human ear, because human being can only hear between frequencies of 20 cycles per second to 20,000 cycles per second. Anything below and above this, the human ear can't hear. You may have heard of the silent dog whistle. The dogs can hear up to 40,000 cycles per second. In the silent dog whistles, the master blows the whistle. The frequency is about 20,000 cycles per second, but below 40,000 cycles per second. The dog can hear, human beings can't hear. So even the plants can feel pain. So there was a non-Muslim who argued with Maxim, Brother Zakir, I agree with you. Plants have got life, plants can feel pain. But the plants have got about two or three senses less. They only have two or three senses. The animals have got five senses. Therefore, killing an animal is the biggest sin. So I told him, for sake of argument, I agree with you that plants have got two senses less. Animals have got five senses, plants have got two or three senses. For sake of argument, I agree with you. But I asked him a question. Suppose you have a brother who's born deaf and dumb, cannot speak, cannot hear. When he grows up, somebody comes and kills him. So will you go and tell the judge, oh my Lord, give the murderer less punishment because my brother was deaf and dumb? You will tell him, give him a bigger punishment. Usne masoom ko mara, he has killed an innocent human being. In Islam, it doesn't work like that. Less senses, five senses, three senses. Allah says in the Quran in Surah Baqarah, chapter number 2, verse number 168, eat of the things which are lawful for you. What is halal for you, you can eat. What is tayyab for you, you can eat. What is good, you can eat.